sentados, mantengan las manos, brazos, pies,
is my favorite place here in Africa. And hopefully you'll get a really good opportunity to see why as we drive through. Point two, point out some of my favorite things to do. And then at the end of the safari, you'll all be my best friend. That's because its branches look like roots going up towards the sky. It's called the Tree of Life because it holds most of its water in its trunk. It's pretty large. It's 2,000 years old. It's my favorite tree. You don't have a favorite tree now. It's my tree. It's so pretty to get us together. There's plenty of trees we can just run. Here we are. But this is Savannah.
Miles and miles and miles
because they need lots of them. They're pretty abundant creatures with all the grasslands. So, look at this beautiful
animal.
Wild Africa, though. We've worked so hard to preserve. We talk a lot about making sure that these animals don't make their way up to extinct animals, but it is also important to remember that we need to protect their natural habitats as well. So, sadly, there are animals on this reserve that we have to say are extinct in the wild. It doesn't matter where you go in the world, they will be kept in captivity. As humans, we all have the power to prevent that from happening. This is for making sure that the earth is habitable, not only for ourselves, but for our fellow creatures as well.
Monkey point.
Monkey Point gets its name from the mandrels that hang out there. That is not what a mandrel sounds like, but I appreciate the sound of that. You missed a couple dozen animals back here, but thanks anyway.
Predator is the human
sadly, both rhinos, black and white, are poached for their horns, which contain keratin. If that's a word that sounds familiar to you, it's because we have keratin in our hair and nails. There are big questions that we already have. We don't necessarily need it more. This is what you would call a crash of rhinos. They call rhinos that are in a group.
There are white rhinos up there.
Your face.
White rhinos are not actually white. They get their name from the Afrikaans word white, which means wide. It's a description of their mouth. Black rhinos have a pointed mouth, which is why you would find them in the forest, where they can grip onto branches and trees. White rhinos have a wide mouth, which is where you're more likely to find them in the grasslands of the savanna, where they can graze. You look up on the left, you might be able to spot the world's fastest mammal. There is a cheetah up there way up at the top. Can be a little hard to see, but that dirt is brown, so just look for a light spot up at the top of that hill. Cheetahs run about 60 to 70 miles per hour. But what many people won't know is that they're actually awful hunters. They go for whatever is slowest and closest if we're sleeping, and that's because they don't have any stamina. If they run 60 to 70 miles per hour to catch their prey, they won't even be able to digest it. They have to take a nap first before their body can take them. Anything else can snatch it up because there are no refrigerators here in the savannah. I can see through the rocks that we are approaching a kopi. You might recognize it. Kopis are notorious in Afghanistan for lions. That reminds me of My Little Eyes. Something black and white coming up. Lions sleep 18 to 20 hours a day, so this isn't the best time to find one, but keep an eye on the kopi because lions do like to tuck themselves in the ground from the privacy of the kopi. There may be a single lion on that. Okay, the green zebras. There are two on the right as well. I'll pull up to the right side of the truck and see it. Grand zebras are black with white stripes. You can tell by looking at their faces. Zebras don't have horns to protect themselves, so they have to use their back legs. It may sound a little ineffective, but their hind kick is so strong, they have been known to break the ribs and jaws of the lions. This looks like a kopi is down here. Let's see what else we can find here. There are two warthogs. They're almost behind us on the left. Warthogs are small, but they are fine. They use their tusks to spot anything that comes across their path. Very cool up ahead. Exactly. Look down on the right. Underneath that mossy tree. Those are ostrich eggs. Everyone want to see the ostrich eggs? Underneath the mossy
tree. Those are eggs from
ostriches.
Birds.
Birds. Thank you so much.
Really big birds.
Big birds.
Not big bird, but a really big bird. On the right, we are a water buck. A water buck gets their name from the unusual amount of water that they drink.
I am bug. Why bumpy? Is it bumpy?
Or not? One question we get a lot is, why are those ostrich eggs by themselves? In case you were wondering. Ostriches have one of the most durable eggs in the world. They weigh about 3 pounds. You can fit over a dozen chicken eggs inside of a single ostrich egg. More impressively, a human can stand on an ostrich egg and it will not break. So they don't worry about their eggs too much. They are the fastest land birds, and can run 40 miles per hour unless they're broken by a truck and they walk zero. We have finally left the savanna. We're taking a little drive through the Makati Glen. It's pretty fun being through here, so make sure that you continue to stay seated. You're welcome through your great job. Take these bumps as slowly as I can so you don't get too jostled. And on the right, There are yellow-billed storks lying down in the grass. Maybe a little hard to see. I know when people hear the word stork, they think, oh, the bird that brings babies. But that is not the stork you want around your shoulder. It is a carnivorous bird that eats other birds, as well as frogs, lizards, and anything it can fit into its mouth. Sadly, this is the end of our safari. If you'd like to see more animals, you can head over to Rafiki's Express Train, which will take you to a backstage area with a petting zoo, meet greets with Rafiki and Josh and stuff, and you can hold ostrich eggs back there. The last train does leave at 4:30, though, so I would recommend going right after the safari. You can also head over to Gorilla Falls, which has gorillas, bear cats, naked mole rats, underwater swimming area, and so many African animals. Or you can head over to Asia, which has Maha Raja Jungle Trek. It's a self-guided walking tour like Gorilla Falls, except for the Asian animals like the tiger and Komodo dragon. And of course, you're always welcome to come back and ride the safari. We are open until 9:30. Tonight's safari is a good opportunity to see some of the nocturnal animals moving around and maybe even vocalizing. I would actually come around sunset. That's my favorite place to be out there. Unfortunately, though, the Asian animals don't have to be wanting to see them. They don't have to be their life, have to touch their family. Conservation Fund, which works tirelessly to make sure that these animals are around for future generations to enjoy. And you can pick up a button. I wear one on my shirt that has an elephant, and we are best friends now, so you can pick up the elephant on a match ring. Or you can pick up the sea turtle on it, because sea turtles are also really cool. But around here, we don't really like to say goodbye. It's sad and it's final, and we hope that you'll come back to see us again. So instead, we say Kwaharini, which means go well. So, my friends, my name is Essence, and I have appreciated the opportunity to thank you all out for the river today. Hope you enjoyed the lesson. Time here. So, Kwaharini, go well and go wild out there.
Watch your step, L. You ain't good.